Hey everybody, Christina Tondevold here. I was just checking to make sure the live stream was working. Been a while since I've done one of these things, but I got a request to do a short video about what number sense is and why it's so important, because I have some long videos, but this one's going to be short. So first thing is I get a lot of questions and concerns really about students' lack of number sense. And it is a huge concern, and I'm not saying it's not, but the hard part is we have to make sure that we define number sense in order to really know what they're lacking. So in today's video, that's what this is all about, is what is it and why is it so important? So I am going to switch over, hopefully here, if I can figure this out. I'm gonna switch over to my screen and share a few things with you that way. So let me see here. This is always fun doing it live. Okay, so we're going to talk about what it is and why it is so essential for our students. So this is the most quoted quote about number sense from Howden, and she says, the part that I love about this that she says is that it develops gradually as a result of exploring numbers, visualizing them, and relating them. And to me, that is what number sense really is all about. I've said it a ton of times, but if you've never heard this, I'm going to repeat it again. Number sense can't be taught. It is caught. Our kiddos develop their number sense through the experiences that they have. That's why we, unfortunately, I guess we have kids coming in to kindergarten with vastly different number sense because they've had vastly different experiences. We have some kids who've gone to preschool for 2 years and maybe have a parent like me who does a lot of experiences for them. And then we've got kiddos who come in with no experiences. And it's not that they don't understand numbers, they just haven't had experiences with them. And it's nothing against parents or anything, but if I didn't have the job that I have, I wouldn't know what to do. You get a lot of info about what to do for reading, but for number sense, there's not a whole lot out there. So what exactly is number sense? And in this quote, she says that it's a good intuition about numbers and their relationships. And every time that I've seen that quote, it has bugged me. I do not like that part of the quote because it doesn't tell me what to do. How do I teach that? And so it wasn't until I saw John Vandewall's work and his colleagues in teaching student-centered mathematics that I really found what I feel like is what number sense truly is, something tangible that I can take and do with my kiddos. So they talk about four relationships that kids need to have to develop their sense of numbers. So here's the first one. The first one is spatial relationships. This goes along with subitizing, however you say it, but it's having a visual to go with a numeral. But it's not just having those visuals, but talking about how they relate. So I can have that visual of three and I can have that visual of four, but really, what does that tell me about three and about four? What kind of relationships can be built once we have those visual pictures? Because if I just have the digit three and the digit four, it doesn't build hardly anything for me as a kiddo, right, about what three and four are, but these visuals do. So giving kids those visuals to go with a number is the first place to start. Then once you have those visuals, you can move into the next three. The second one that they talk about is that kids need to know instantly what is one and two, more and less. If I just give a digit six and ask the kids what's one more, just knowing that seven, the digit seven is next, doesn't really tell me much about it. But if I have a visual like this math rack, the top one is showing six, the bottom one is showing seven, that helps me understand better about six and seven and how it is one less and one more than each other, okay? The third one is the benchmarks of 5 and 10. So taking that visual idea, we want to have visuals, but the visuals matter. So I could have a string of 9 things and say that's a visual representation of 9. It is, but it doesn't help me develop what 9 really is in relationship to other things. And the benchmarks of 5 and 10 are really, really huge. So taking those 9 things, putting them into the 10 frame helps develop how 9 relates to 5 and how it relates to 10, along with seeing that it's 9 individual things. We get to develop the relationship. The last one is being able to understand that a whole can be broken into parts and that parts come together to make a whole. So I know textbooks do a great job of having us break all of these apart. We do lots of activities with number bonds and whatever else you may call them, but being able to show all the parts that make the whole. We'll do that with the numerals, but we also want to do them with the visuals to help kids have the visual aspect. But it's also really important to spend time talking about not just what are all the ways you can break apart 7, but when would you break 7 into a 1 and a 6 versus a 2 and a 5? What's the point of being able to break that apart? Now, here's my spiel a little bit about why it's important, because we have all of these standards being thrown at us, and this is just a sampling of some of the standards that are out there, but really, it's not about focusing on that standard. If you focus on developing sense for your students, all of these standards become so much easier to do, okay? So let's look at a really quick example. Let's say I want to do 9 plus 7, and I could just have kids memorize 9 plus 7, no big deal. But if we spend time developing relationships and we have visuals to go along with 9 plus 7, and kids are starting to develop that, wow, 9 plus 7 is really like having 10 plus 6. I could take one and give it and fill the 10 frame. Like if they have that visual in their mind, I could fill the 10 frame and then I just have 6 left over. That's awesome. And it seems, you know, like if, I'm like, oh, that takes like a lot of time. I could just memorize it. But the power of building number sense is that it lasts beyond just like their facts like this. And let's say we move into problems like this, where we have to add and subtract and become fluent within 1,000. Well, doing this problem, yes, I could stack it, do the traditional algorithm, but man, this problem would be so much nicer if I could just move one over and create 300, and then now I've got 300 and 356. That problem is way nicer than stacking it. And so having that number sense really isn't even just for whole numbers. As kids start to move into decimals, doing a problem like this becomes so much nicer, right? We all hate decimals and fractions, but think about how much nicer this problem can be when we think, I get that benchmark of the whole number, the benchmark of 4, I just got to bring 1 hundredth over. Now I have 4 and 16 hundredths right there in front of me. And the dreaded fractions. Now I know, sorry about my formatting here. It's hard to get fractions into a PowerPoint. But if I have 3 and a half plus 5 3/4, how can I make one of those nicer? How could I make it friendlier? Okay? Being able to build these relationships for kids isn't just about the strategies. It's about developing relationships that kids can see and notice and use on all types of problems. So those 4 number sense relationships are the real key ones that I want you to be developing. Okay? Get the spatial relationships going in your classroom. Get 1 and 2 more and less, which then moves into 10 more and less, 100 more and less, then the benchmarks of 5 and 10. And when you're doing fractions and decimals, those benchmarks become the whole numbers and the halves. Those become benchmark numbers. And part, whole, being able to break numbers apart and know when to break them apart is an essential piece of that. If we can develop those things for our kids, it makes all of the other standards so much easier. I know it's hard to slow down and spend some time focusing on number sense, but if you do, you can actually speed up through a whole lot more of the standards and your curriculum, because kids will get it a whole lot faster. Instead of taking a lesson and having to spend 3 or 4 days on it because it's not clicking with the kids, if we can slow down and take the time to develop their number sense, then the standards that we need to be addressing this year become a whole lot easier. Now, I know this was a very quick overview, but that's what I was asked to do. So it's a quick overview of what number sense is, but I have a free ebook that you can download that goes a little bit more into detail about those 4 number sense relationships and also has an assessment. Now, I'll forewarn you, this assessment is for pre-K to second grade. I don't have it built for the fractions and decimals piece. But for whole numbers, being able to assess and figure out which of those 4 areas your kiddos are not as developed in yet is a great piece to be able to start off the school year. So you can find that by going to buildmathminds.com/numbersense. No space in between, number sense is all one word. So I hope that this has helped you build some your math mind so that you can go build the math minds of your students. Have a great day.